Good morning, students. Today let us learn the rules for arithmetic operations with significant numbers. Yesterday we have learned what is a significant number. Expressing any number or result in the form of a into 10 to the power of b is called as significant number. Here a is any real number and b is the exponent. And b is called as the exponent, the power. Now, today we will learn the rules for arithmetic operations with significant figures. In case when two or more results are needed to be multiplied or divided, like calculation of area, length and breadth are to be multiplied. Calculation of density, mass by volume has to be calculated. Then these physical quantities will be having their own certain and uncertain numbers. So we need to follow certain rules while carrying out this multiplication and division of such physical quantities having certain uncertain significant numbers and insignificant numbers. Let us see. In multiplication or division, the final result should retain as many significant figures as there are in the original number with least significant figures. Repeat. In multiplication or division, the final result should retain as many significant figures as there in the original number with least significant figures. What is the meaning of this? Let us see this second example first. There are two quantities being multiplied, 5.879 into 4.65. 5.879, let us say it is the length, 4.65, it is the measured breadth. So length into breadth gives us area of a rectangle. So if you calculate area of a rectangle by multiplying length and breadth, then we get the result. The result will be 27.337735, and then we need to follow this rule number 1. What it says, the result should have so many decimal places as it is there in the original number with the least significant figure. So here out of these two, this 4.65 is having least significant figure. The first one is having 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 significant figures. Second one is having 1, 2, 3, 3 significant figures. So the result should have the least one, that is 3 significant figures. 1, 2, 3. So it should have 3 significant figures. So it is restricted to 1, 2, 3. So it becomes 27.3 centimeter square if it is area. So this is the rule. Now let us see the second example, calculation of density. Suppose mass of a sample measured in the laboratory is 4.237 gram. Mass of a sample measured is 4.237 gram and its volume is 2.51 centimeter cube. These are the experimental results. We need to calculate density. Density is equal to mass by volume, right? Then 4.237 divided by 2.51, the actual result comes out to be, if you calculate this, 1.68804780876. You can see 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11, 11 decimal places, or you can see 12 significant figures. There are 12 significant figures which appears to be absurd, irrelevant. Therefore, we need to apply this rule. Out of these two given quantities, which one is having least significant figure? You see, the volume has least significant figure, that is 3. So we must restrict the result to 3 significant figures. So 1.69, if you restrict here, 1.6880. So the next number is greater than 5, therefore the preceding number should be raised by 1. That is the rule for rounding up. rounding off. So 1.688 becomes 1.69. So the least number of significant figures in this case is 3 significant figures. So the answer should also be having 3 significant figures. So this is the rule for either multiplication or division. Now let us see second one. In case it is addition or subtraction, like the addition of masses, right? Addition of lengths in the case of perimeter of a rectangle. So in such cases of addition or subtraction, the final result should retain as many decimal places as are. As many decimal places as are there in the number with least decimal places. Again, similar rule. The number having least decimal places, whatever the number of decimal places it is having, the final result should also have same decimal places. Look at this one example. 6.121. Let us say these are masses. 6.121 plus 7.4. gram plus 8.123 gram. These are the measured values of different quantities, masses. If you add all these, the total mass becomes 21.644. If you add all these, we get the result 21.644. But the rule says, you look at the number which is having least decimal places. So it is having only one decimal place. One decimal place, that is 0.4. So you must restrict to one decimal place, 21.6. So further number is 44, which is less than 5. So you must retain that number as it is. You should not increase it by 1. Suppose this further number is more than 5. If it is 64, then you have to add 1. To round off, so it becomes 21.7. In case if this insignificant numbers are greater than 5, that is the rules for rounding off. So this is one. So you must stick to the number which is having least decimal place. Similarly, let us see the second one. 436.32 gram plus 227.2 gram plus 0.301 gram. So if you add this, we get 663.821 gram. So again look at the number which is having least decimal place. The second one is having least decimal place, that is only 1. Therefore the result must be restricted to only 1 decimal place. 663.8 up to first decimal place. The remaining number is less than 5, so you need not go for rounding off. You can keep it as it is. So these are the rules for arithmetic operations with significant figures. Right? Now let us learn some more rules for rounding up and rounding down. Rules for rounding off. Okay, now let us learn rules for rounding off. Rules for rounding off. First, if the preceding digit is the preceding digit is to be raised by 1, if the insignificant number is greater than 5. If the insignificant number is greater than 5. For example, let us take this example. Example number 1. 5.4759. You are asked to round off up to 3 decimal places. Up to 3 decimal places means after decimal place, decimal point 1, 2, 3. Up to 3 decimal places. So you are asked to round off up to this. The next digit is insignificant. This insignificant number, if it is greater than 5, then what you have to do? You have to raise the preceding number by 1. So the answer becomes 5 plus 1 here, since 9 is greater than 5. So 5.7479 4759. When it is rounded off to 3 decimal places, it becomes 4.476. I think you already learnt in chemistry also. Same, roots are same. Whatever you have learnt. If you are asked to round off to 1 decimal place, if you are asked to round off to 1 decimal place, up to first decimal place, you see, the next decimal place is 7. 7 is greater than 5. If 7 is greater than 5, then what happens? We have to write, you have to just add 1 to this, then it becomes 5.7. If it is for 1 decimal place, 5.4759 becomes 5.5. Simple, 5.5. Now, if the preceding digit is, so you see here, the preceding digit is to be left unchanged if the latter is greater than 5. If the latter one is less than 5. Suppose the insignificant number, let us see the second example, insignificant number here after 3 decimal places is 3. You are asked to round off up to 3 decimal place. Up to 3 decimal place. 1, 2, 3. Next number is insignificant. So, this insignificant number, look at it. If it is less than 5, so 3 is less than 5, then what happens? You have to leave it unchanged. So, if you round it off to 3 decimal places, it becomes 5.4753. Becomes up to 3 decimal place means 1, 2, 3. 5.475. So this is the rounding off. This is the rule for rounding off. So if the insignificant number, the last number, is more than 5, add 1. Increase the preceding number by 1. If the insignificant number is less than 5, no need to increase, no need to decrease. If the insignificant number is less than 5, then keep it as it is, leave it as it is. You will be left with 4.475. Okay. What if the terminating result, the terminating digit is 5? If it is neither 9 nor 3, suppose if it is 5. If it is 5, then what is the rule? The rule says that if the preceding digit is even, if the last insignificant number is 5, then what is the rule? Then if the preceding digit is even, leave it as it is. If the preceding digit, look at this example, 2.745. So suppose you are asked to round off up to 2 decimal places. The third decimal place is 5. Then how to round it off? Neither it is greater than 5 nor it is less than 5. It is exactly 5. Then look at the preceding number. The preceding number is 4, which is even. If it is even, then leave it as it is. It becomes 2.74 up to 2 decimal places. Up to 2 decimal places. Similarly, if the preceding digit is odd, if it is even, leave it as it is. If the preceding digit here in this case, it is odd, 3 is odd number. So, in this case, we need to increase it by 1, add 1 to that. Then it becomes 2.74. 2.74 up to 2 decimal places. So these are the rules to follow. I think you are aware of all these things. You need to apply these whenever you go for calculations, whenever you go for actual numerical problems. Now let us solve some 2 problems. Okay, let us solve these problems. Calculate surface area of a cube of size 7.203 cm. Side of the cube is 7.203. You are asked to calculate surface area. Second problem is to calculate volume of the cube to appropriate significant figures. You know already how to calculate surface area of a cube. Cube has six surfaces. So 6 times surface area of each area, 6 times the area of each surface area gives us total surface area. But the question is to appropriate significant figures. That is the important thing. Such questions will be asked. Now, surface area of a cube is equal to 6 times into area of each surface. Area of each surface is side into side. Side square. So this becomes 6 into 7.203 into 7.203. So these are the measured values. So we have to look into these measured values and the final result. So if you calculate this, the answer comes out to be 311.299254 centimeter square. Centimeter square. This is in surface area. So to appropriate significant figures, now look into this measured values. 7.203. So the number of significant figures, here is 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. It means we have to restrict the result up to 4 significant figures. 1, 2, 3, 4. So when you are restricted to the 4 significant figure, it is going to be first decimal point. But the next one is more than 5. So it should be rounded off. So if you round it off and you restrict to the appropriate significant figures, it becomes 311.3 centimeter square, because it has 4 significant figures. So when it is having 4 significant figures, the answer should also have 4 significant figures. The answer should also have 4 significant figures. This is what we are supposed to see. And before writing the fourth one, you should see that it is rounded off following the rules. So this is the first one. The second one is to calculate the volume of the cube. Now we will calculate the second one. Volume of the cube. Volume of cube is equal to side into side into side. Side. Cube. Cube of side. So it becomes 7.203 whole cube. 7.203 whole cube, if you calculate, it comes out to be 373.714 centimeter cube. This is in centimeter cube because it is volume. Again, you have to restrict up to 4 decimal places. I mean, sorry, 4 significant figures. You have to restrict up to 4 significant figures. 1, 2, 3, 4. So here, from 1, 2, 3, 4. So the answer becomes 373.7. The next number is less than 5, so you can keep it as it is. Centimeter cube. So this is having 4 significant figures. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 significant figures. So the answer should also have 4 significant figures. So this is how we have to check by applying the rules. Now quickly let us see the second one. 5.74 gram of a substance occupies 1.2 centimeter cube. Express its density by keeping the significant figures in the view. Express its density by keeping the significant figures in the view. So you are asked to calculate the density. These are the measured values. So we know density equal to mass by volume. Mass is 5.74 gram 0.2 cm³. Now you see, you have to apply the rule of the arithmetic operations, keeping in view of significant figures. For arithmetic operation, here the operation is division. So when the division takes place, the result should be having that many number of decimal places, which is possessed by one of the physical quantities here. So the denominator is having only two significant figures. The numerator is having three significant figures. So once we get the result should be restricted to only two significant figures. Let us see. 12 fours are 48. So 12 fours are 48. 9 hundreds 94. 12 sevens are 84. 10 minutes. So 12 eights are 96. So gram per centimeter cube. This is the answer. But it should be restricted to only two significant figures. So the least one is two significant figures. So you will have 4.8 gram per centimeter cube. Here it is rounded off. This becomes insignificant, uncertain number. So the preceding one is to be added with 1. This should be increased by 1. So it becomes 4.8 gram per centimeter. So this is how you are supposed to solve the problems, by keeping in view all the rules for operation of arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, keeping in view of these significant figures. So we can solve such kind of problems from the exercise, so that in the next we will study the very important one, that is dimensions of physical quantities and dimensional formulae and dimensional equations. Once we study those dimensions of physical quantities, dimensional formulae and dimensional equations, that concludes this topic. So the next one which we are going to study, it's going to be very, very important, not only from the point of view of physics, it is also very important even in other branches of science. Okay, so thank you, have a nice day, good day.